Oh, hi there. Remember this game? Frostpunk. So, I have played this a couple of years ago, and I was going through my Steam library just to see what would be nice to stream on the channel. So I thought, let's give Frostpunk a go, because it's been quite a while, and it was a fun little game. It's like a survival city builder game, but then you have only limited space and it's very cold and you need to keep everybody warm and fuzzy in their houses. So let's just go ahead and start the main story. I don't really remember how the story goes, but we just have to see what's happening. Let's see, what can we choose? Let's just go for the default probably. And then let's see what happens. I will pause while the game loads for you.
Still cold.
Right. Very cold and very snowy. That is going to be the idea of Frostpunk. So the story goes like some people escape the city in some kind of an engine. And the engine is the only thing that keeps them warm. So we have to fuel the engine at all times until we either die or survive.
Until the frost.
So let's go ahead and skip this and jump right into the game to see our only source of heat, at least for now. I believe there are some research things you can do. So yeah, fight the cold. Ah, generator. It's called the generator, not the engine. Provides heat and power to buildings. Without it, we will freeze to death. Yeah, so if we just pause the game here for a second, it's just like a very, very cold and strange place, like a crater. And we have some people. Yep, there they are. And we have like a certain amount of heat. We can activate the generator, and then it has a round area where it heats the buildings. And at certain points in time we have the temperature. Oh, that's right about here, the temperature. And yeah, we literally just need to make sure that our people don't freeze. And at some point in time the temperature will drop, and at some point in time the temperature will rise. And yeah, we'll either are going to survive or everyone will be destroyed. So yeah, let's see if I remember how to play it. We have this is a stockpile, so we definitely need a tent for the people to sleep in. There is also something like roads, I believe. So let's see. Oh, here's the road. So I do remember that you want. We can just move the tents over, so cancel. I do remember that you want to leave some kind of space for road, but apparently it just goes in between the buildings, so we can build the tent right next to here. And let's run the game. Yeah, play. And we need to collect some coal. So how does this work again? What is this? Steel, is this cool? This is wood. So yeah, we should deploy some workers or something like that. Oh yeah, workers. So we are going to assign 5 workers to that wood. And is there also coal? Steel, yeah. Also, let's do this steel. Is this coal? Oh, that needs a coal mine. Here is coal. There we go. So we have 15 people in total, I believe. Let's see, where can we see that? Ah, there we go. Unemployed. So we can definitely assign more people to the raw resources here. Yeah, none here. I wanted to do this, and then 5 more around here. So let's give them maybe a road. I don't want to build a road yet, because I'm not sure if there's a downside of building the roads. Probably they move a lot quicker, so it might be worth to just build a road here. And then maybe get rid of the road if we need to build something else. So we built one tent, so 10 people can now sleep. Yeah, 10 out of the, what was it, 80 people. So yeah, medical post, cookhouse, hunter's hut, resource depot, storage, gathering post. That's also nice to build, I think, instead of manually assign them to the piles of resources. And the workshop, so that's like the research center. There are also laws in this game, which I don't think I can do anything right now. You need certain points, but you can choose between some like, it's like research. You can spend points to unlock things. And there are also a lot of these graph like thingies where you can see how many days you how much you are gaining and how much you are spending. So I don't know if I need to activate the generator already, or that this is still fine. So very low risk of falling ill. Yeah, so the tent provides some heat. Where was it? I don't know. But like the tents provide some kind of heat. So they are, for now, they are fine staying in there without the need to turn on the generator. But it is our first objective. We need to have coal. So I'm just going to put every available person I have to here. I believe the engineers are required for certain jobs, like work at some kind of machinery. And we also have these deposits. I believe they are unlimited. Unlimited supply. So yeah, I might as well just add a couple of engineers to these jobs, because they let them work. I will keep 5 available to build some stuff if I want. And I'm just going to increase the game speed a bit, because it might be a bit slow at the start. So yeah, there is some like a cold wave coming. Oh, we also going to need food, by the way. I forgot about that. So let's see. You are really for fixing people. And there we have a... Yeah, we need a cookhouse and a hut probably. This provides up to 15 food. So you can see how the placement of things is working. It's like it has more area the farther you are away from the generator, but also the heat from the generator, you have certain amount of levels that there are like ranges and temperature settings, so you need to keep in mind that the things you place further away are not going to be heated. Also, you have these random events like lack of shelter. Then you have the discontent, and if that's get too high, you get, I'm not sure if it's game over or something of a riot. I believe it's something of a riot. And if you say I will provide shelter for everyone, then they will be very happy if you manage to do this in 2 days. But I'm not sure how quickly I can build, so I just do provide some shelter, so that's shelter for 30 people. And you know, let's provide shelter for everyone. Let's provide shelter for everyone. That means I need to make 8 tents. And that means we will need a lot of wood. The generator is off. People are afraid if you don't turn it on. Yes, okay, so I will. They really want me to turn it on. So, okay. I'll turn it on. Yes, thank you very much. Perfect. And if you now check the temperature overlay, we can see that things are getting heated here. Also, the hunter's hut has more protection than a tent, so this is like a larger heat level. Let's see, there is also like work shifts here in this game, so now they have free time. I am not really sure if you can set it. It might be possible that you can change it over that they work harder or something like that. Also, I'm going to reduce the amount of people from this code pile and assign them to this hut, because we will definitely need to eat. Or for example, you can see the working hours here. They work during the night. And because this building has insulation, it's comfortable here. Here it's also comfortable because it's within the heat zone of the generator. You will see that it only heats this area, so it doesn't heat the Anders hut. But as it's not too cold and this has quite a good insulation, there are no issues over here. And then we've got these stockpiles. The working hours are here listed again. And you can see that's chilly and there is a low risk of them getting ill. And certainly at some point in time, everybody will get ill and sick, and then you really lose your workforce. And yeah, if your workforce collapses, then you don't have enough to make food or care for the sick or mine coal, because really there is a stockpile of coal. So you can see that my current stockpile lasts about a day, so I will need to continuously mine coal. And we already got sick, but I just need to continuously mine coal in order to really survive, because if the generator stops and it's really cold, then it's like game over, because everybody will get sick and freeze to death and stuff like that. Wood, steel and steam cores were some like advanced resource you can find on the map. There is a map, by the way, but I think we need a building before we can access the map, so I'm not really really sure about that right now. So yeah, I'm just going to increase the time, and we get another event here, number of sick. We don't have enough materials to build a short burst of effort. Let's see. Ah, yes. So now you get like a suggestion, like maybe you want to have an emergency shift. You can, that's the law, that's not really research, but it laws. And you can then force them to work for 24 hours in trade off some this content. I am definitely going to sign this, because if at some point we are very low on coal and risk on losing the entire colony, then we can really make sure that we force our people to work. I am not sure yet how to activate this. So I guess we won't be using it for now. Or do I activate it here? Maybe it is. Is it now? Is it currently activated? No, I signed this. Ability. Yeah. Well, I don't know how to activate it, to be honest. So I guess we have to wait for that maybe to become available. Maybe there's like a cooldown or something. So let's don't forget to queue up a couple of more tents. And I don't have enough food, so it would be nice to have some more people on wood. So let's just add the engineers to this this wood pile. I believe that stops the buildings from being built, but at this point I just need the wood, because they will be unhappy. So I am building the tents all the way around the generator, so that they get the heat. And I'm probably also going to be needing a medical post relatively soon. That requires 25 food, so yeah, that will take some time. 4 people sick. Oh, here are probably my hunters coming back. So that means we get raw food. I believe they can eat raw food, but it doesn't provide as much nutrition as cooked food. Generator hums with reassuring warmth, but we shouldn't take it for granted. Yeah, if the generator goes down, the city dies. Exactly. Food, we starve. Yes, raw food, excellent. I just built that. So yeah, that's already the next thing. Steel records is already depleted. Pause the game. I don't really need steel at this point, so I'm going to assign most of our people to the wood crates here. so that I can build a couple of more tents around the generator. I think Freeze should do it. And then get the cookhouse. Oh, there's, by the way, the heating level in the pop-up. This says base heating level 1. And for example, the Hunter's Hut has base heating level 2. So you will know that the this one will be one level warmer. Like, or comfortable. Comfortable, and then you have, like, this one, livable. And then you have chilly, I think, and freezing. Or maybe there's one in between, I'm not entirely sure. But in like a day, the temperature will drop. Yay! Very nice. So this lowers my discontent now. There is like a naturally increase in that because people are living in the cold and don't like it. So by completing it, they are now a bit more happy. So I'm not really sure where I can see if everybody is has a home, but I guess we'll see. So yeah, the temperature will drop significantly, so that will lower the temperature of everything. So we might increase the heat of our generator because we can unlock stuff like this. And yeah, this will really just increase the heat level of the generator or the range. But yes, we definitely need to research it. Oh yeah, I believe exactly, research is the workshop. Yeah, so you have the laws and research and economy. We can pass another law, it seems. There is always a cooldown, so you need to be on the lookout of that. So we can do a fighting area that will reduce discount content. That's nice. We can research soup. That's, yeah, instead of a full meal, so you have more meals people can eat, but it lowers their discontent, or it increases their discontent. At sawdust, they don't like really that. You have like different types of treatments. Do you want to focus on healing people or just getting them back to work as soon as possible? Cemetery or snow pit? Or do you want child laborers to work with the increased chance of them being injured in accidents? Or do you want child shelters, but you need to build them? So I'm not going to do that right now because, yeah, I'm still really not entirely sure how this game works exactly because it's been a long time. So the first thing I want to do is build a cookhouse, but we get another event. Resource shortage. Yeah, hell yes, you're already suggesting me to do extended shift, right? Working overtime. Yeah, you know, I might just sign this. And where was it? Was it here? Yeah, so I can increase the shift time of certain buildings, so people will work there longer. But that will increase the discontent. So it doesn't seem to matter for the Hunter's Hut. But yeah, now they're going to work. But it just gives a bit of extra resource. Also, I believe if the hope runs out, you're also game over. So you have to really manage two things. You have to keep them happy, keep them warm. Don't make them really really sad. So let's make sure that we have a cookhouse. And I'm also going to... Yeah, I have to build it probably around here. Because we will get a cold, like a cold wave. But you see that it does use a lot of space. And it also is... Yeah, so you can not build everything you want. Wood crates have been depleted. That's unfortunate. Let's go for the next wood crates. Here was the emergency shift button. Yeah, so just emergency shift is also just for a single building. Why are you hungry? Basic resources. We can try to rescue people. Yes. Indeed, you can build a beacon, scout the land, And then you get really access to the map and rescue other people and stuff like that. Also, we can... Yes, we will build 4 food rations from 2 raw food. So we're now converting our raw food into rations. And I think we are going to need another of these guys. Just to make sure that we are having plenty of food. Although I don't have enough people yet to support it. So I think we are definitely going to build... Where well, I think we need to research it first. Oh, you know what? We are going to need a medical post. Yeah. Also, this medical post also has heating level 1, as you could say. So it would be best to build it in the heated area. But yeah, there is simply no room. So this medical post will get cold as soon as we hit this temperature drop. It may even be chilly, so we have to see about that. More sick beds. Yes, I will open a medical post. And, you know, yeah, just do this one. Because I just built it, so why not? We are getting a bit of wood, so that's nice. Our resources are... Yeah, we do have some lying around. We have to keep an eye on it. Because we have to make sure that we, at a certain point in time, go and mine these other areas. Because they supply a bit more resources than the things that are lying around. Yeah, we don't really have people for this guy. And we also need people working in the hospital. So, as this one seems to be doing more, it's cooking more than we can provide, I'm going to lower the amount of people. Healthcare promise fulfilled. Yes, that raises hope and lowers discontent. Now there are some people going to here to be treated, and that will take some time. And yeah, then they will be able to work again. So the next thing I'm going to do is build this workshop. What is the heat level of this guy? It has heat level 2, so it doesn't really matter where I built it, because it is heated efficiently, so I can even build it like further away. But this might be a great place. It needs to be on a street. So you can build a street wherever you want, and you can also build streets like around this edge, like something like this. So doesn't really matter. But I don't want to place them just now. So if we have this research, then I definitely want to make like the beacon, I believe. Yeah, build the beacon so that we can at least see the map and yeah, really try and find other people and stuff like that. Here we have the technology. Yes, the technologies. I remember this. So yeah, there are a lot of things that are nice to research, and that's where your steel goes. So the steam hubs build smaller generators. You can increase the heaters. Oh, you can add heaters to a workplace in case it's out of range and you want it. There's the beacon. Faster gathering. Yes, you have like the coal mines, etc. Sawmill, steelworks. Research for additional food. So, but first we are going to do the beacon that will require 20 wood and 35 steel and a couple of hours. So that's just the most important time. We can speed up research by adding more people here. But for now I'm just going to increase the working hours. Because I don't really have enough people. What's your problem? Efficiency breakdown. Oh, one is in treatment, so it's not running at full efficiency. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. I know that that we got a couple of sick people. Gravely ill. If you sign the radical treatment law, the gravely ill will be treated in medical post, but may undergo risky amputations. You might say sustain life to keep them alive until we build an infirmary. So, let's see. Hope will rise. Ferdy will be left as amputees. Discontent will lie. Will rise slightly, and if you do sustain life, you will remain a burden, they will take a bath. So let's just quickly check the research and see where is the medical building they are talking about. Because if that's easy to do, then I won't mind waiting. Food, health and shelter. Medical post? No, they were talking about an infirmary, right? So it's at least two levels down. So we also need to research these levels before we can unlock it. So yeah, that's two levels down, so I am not going to do that. So we are going to radical treatment with the chance of people being amputees, and that lowers their performance, but at least they are not taking up beds in my medical building, and I don't want that. If they're just staying here and not getting healed, then I need to keep having more and more buildings, and I don't really have the place for that. So coal pile depleted, let's build another coal. Now let's pause the game. You can see that it's getting very cold. You can see the temperature is about to drop to minus 40. I believe every level is 10 degrees. And you can see that this is listed as very cold. High risk of falling ill, low risk of becoming gravely ill. So it would be best to stop the operation of this. We have like 2 days. And we have about 2 days of coal. So if we stop this building, then at least we lower the amount of people that get sick, or sick is fine, but gravely ill. So you are also cold. Why too cold? This building must be at least chilly. All right, so apparently I should have built this in the inner range, because it requires at least a chilly temperature. So let's increase. This building also takes only engineers, by the way, so that's what I was saying about certain job requiring engineers. So as I now have a surplus of people, I will fill up these buildings and just withdraw everybody from those other places. And that might improve the speed here a bit. And then I can maybe do heaters. Maybe I should do heaters first. Oh, I can't. Can I cancel this? Yes, I can abort it. I hope this will keep my research process. Because if I do heaters, then I can install heaters in this medical building. And even though it's out of range, I can... they can really be warm. But yeah, you just have to manage your game a bit. Because you want to have enough coal to survive the cold periods. And of course, you can still send people here, or you can build heaters to heat this place up. But it's just about managing your resources and seeing how it goes. Built a workshop, didn't reach. Yeah, excellent. We will definitely hurry to get our other people. So I'm just going to speed up time a bit, because nothing is really happening. And yeah, now we have heaters, and we can install a heater here. Oh, the heaters are already free, so that's great. So this is now at least chilly, because it is minus 2 from the weather, plus 1 from insulation, and plus 1 for the heater. But this does require 1 coal an hour, so we have to keep an eye on this. You don't have a lot of... Yeah, so you're not working because we don't have raw food. And you are not working because there's no research. That is cute. So let's continue on the beacon. It does seem to restart, so that's unfortunate. Alright, but I will make the cut for this episode here. I hope you like it. If you do, let me know. If you want to see some other games, just let me know what you would like to see. And yeah, let's see if we can keep everybody healthy in this game. So thank you for watching, and see you next time. Bye.